Today, we kick off a new parenting segment designed to help answer some of your questions. Dr. Carrie Wijesinghe, the owner and medical director of Sienna Pediatrics, joining us this afternoon. Hi, Dr. Carrie, for short. That's what I've called you all these years. Thanks so much for your time today and for helping us kick off a brand new segment here on 8 News Now at 4.
Thank you for having me.
Indeed, indeed. Well, Dr. Carrie, now that 16-year-olds are eligible for the COVID vaccine, what concerns are parents sharing with you, and what would you like to share with our viewers?
I think the safety is the number one concern parents are always articulating to me, and I just pretty much reassure them in the exam room that these trials have been going on for a while in the adults, but even in the 16 and 17-year-olds now, it's very safe. And I go over the things like it's the Pfizer vaccine is the only vaccine right now for 16 and 17-year-olds, and I go over the side effects with them.
Okay. And what are some of those side effects?
So they fever, sore arm, nausea, fatigue. Any of us that have had the vaccine can definitely tell you that that is a mess. Yes.
That's right. And they typically pass within the 24 to 48-hour period. Dr. Carrie, the CDC has reported the spread of COVID nationwide very low at schools. Some families have still chosen to continue with distance learning. Others have brought their kids back in. What do you encourage for these kids once school lets out for the summer?
I mean, we're really encouraging them to get out, get outside. The number of kids with low vitamin D has been an all-time high. So get out there. Sunscreen, of course. But, yeah, go to the summer camps. The CDC just released some new guidelines regarding that. Pretty much stay 3 feet apart, you know, during activities. Wear your mask and hand sanitize.
And mental health, certainly, as I know we've discussed, it's been a key concern among children and teens during this pandemic, the depression, the isolation some are experiencing. What are some key indicators, doctor, that your child could be really struggling, and what advice do you have for parents?
Thank you for asking that. It's been a huge number of children that I've taken care of this year that have depression and anxiety. So key symptoms are changes of behavior. You can have a child who's, you know, more aggressive or more apathetic regarding their friends and their activities, weight loss, changes of their clothing. They won't be basically wearing their normal style. They won't be taking showers appropriately, too. So yes.
Okay, and there's always help out there for parents. They can contact the local resources. Of course, there are many numbers and online, as well as their local pediatricians, correct?
Correct. And we are screening now for depression and anxiety more than ever. And we can be an aid. We're sending people to get more therapy. We can even help with medications if need be, too.
Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Carrie. We greatly appreciate your time, and we look forward to having you back in real soon. So once again, so nice to see you, and thank you for your time.
Good to see you, too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Take care.